ekiseera kijja tukwatagane naye, Allah asalewo wakati waffe naye. Muli redde?
Allahu akbar.
For 20 years, Jamil Mukuru, the leader of the Allied Democratic Forces, has been on the run.
Ye ingredient tulinga bola bomugati naye nga omugati okufuuka omugati ndi baguteeka awo guberenga guliibwa gubeera guyise mitendera era muberamu ebirunga ebiteekeddwamu.
Today he has been paraded before journalists at Nalufenya police station in Jinja.
After the Tanzanian authorities, especially the courts, were convinced.
Mukuru, a former Catholic turned Muslim, appeared to be in prayer as cameras shattered.
Before I came here, I asked him whether he was satisfied about his treatment. In spite of what we know of what him and his care of.
Police Chief General Kale Kaihura says Mukuru's extradition to Uganda is an affirmation of the rule of law in Tanzania and Uganda.
The ADF rebel chief Jamil Mukuru, his real name David Amos Mazengo, who is a Ugandan national, was extradited from the United Republic of Tanzania to Uganda on murder charges.
Kaihura says Mukuru is a wanted man in Uganda for a series of crimes including terrorism and murder.
Oh, Jamil Mukuru is already in court. He's already on a charge sheet facing Jinja Road Magistrate, Chief Magistrate's Court. It's just that he was still at large. Now we have got him. So, as soon as the courts are ready to for us to present him, you will be presented. I can't put a date because I don't control the calendar of the courts.
He also warned all those planning to wage war in the country to henceforth desist from it and called upon the remaining ADF rebels to give up.
There is a time for everything. There was a time for war. Now, war is not necessary in Uganda. How many ADFs were captured or surrendered and are now were given amnesty and they are just doing their business? So, it's a lost cause. Unless they are waiting just to be captured, to be caught like grasshoppers, which will happen, by the way. It's just that we are not interested in them. If they attempt to come to Uganda, they will see what will happen to them. But let them just give up, come home, just slowly walk through panyas and go back to their villages.
The ADF rebels launched an insurgency in mid-1980s and later established bases on the Congolese side of the border. They are accused of looting, forced enlistment of child soldiers, and illegal trade in tropical timber. A notice issued by Interpol states that Jamil Mukuru faces charges of grave massacres and breach of Article 147 of the 4th Geneva Convention. Mukuru converted to Islam and later formed the ADF in 1989, citing discrimination against Muslims. At the time, he was considered the overall leader of the South section of the Tabligh Muslims. The United States listed the ADF as a terrorist organization in 2001, and the Ugandan government accuses it of links to Somalia's Al-Shabaab and Al-Qaeda. At the time of his arrest in Tanzania on the 19th March 2015, Mukuru was trying to procure a travel document for one of his children. Samuel Senono and Joseph Bole for UBC TV News.